Hello and welcome to High Voltages. In this video, we are going to talk about MQTT again. In this video, I will teach you how you can create a basic web application using MQTT protocol. For this, we will be working on HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So you can say that this tutorial will teach you how to make a MQTT web application or web dashboard using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. We will not be focusing much on the HTML and CSS side and will be mainly talking about the functionality or backend using JavaScript. The frontend in this video is going to be really simple and we will not be diving in the details of the frontend, but obviously you can create a nice looking dashboard. Without further delay, let's start with a question. Why do we need a web app for the MQTT project? You can control your MQTT devices from mobile apps and dashboard. So why do we need a browser? By the way, I have uploaded the tutorial for both mobile app and dashboard. Links will be in the description. A browser is installed on nearly every desktop, computer, laptop, tablet, smartphone around the world. And also, it would be nice if you could use one protocol to get messages on all type of devices, browsers, tablets, smartphones, embedded devices, sensors, etc. Another question. How MQTT works on the web? To use MQTT, we will use websockets. So the question is, what are websockets? Websocket is a computer communication protocol. And it provides full duplex communication, that means both ways, over a single TCP IP function. And since we all know our browsers uses HTTP or secure HTTP protocol for communication, WebSocket is associated with HTTP as it uses it for initial connection. The client and the server or both devices start their connection using HTTP and then upgrades to WebSockets. Coming back to our last question, how can we use MQTT in the browser and how is it different from the normal MQTT messages? I have explained the flow of normal MQTT messages in detail. You will find the link in the description. But in short, it works on the publish-subscribe model. And if we use MQTT on WebSockets, then MQTT messages are placed into WebSocket envelope and then it is sent to the client using TCP IP protocol. And when the client receives the packet, he first unpacks the MQTT message from the WebSocket envelope and then it is processed as a normal MQTT message. Now you know how we can use MQTT in a web browser. Let's write code for the web app. But before that, I would like you to subscribe and like this video. Also, questions are welcome in the comments. Since this project can be used to control your ESP32, Raspberry Pi, Arduino, sensors, etc. and you would like to get a PCB which will save you hassle of wiring, consider PCBWay.com, who is the sponsor of this video. PCBWay also provides the CNC services and they are experts in their field. You will find the link to their website in the description. Go check them out. Okay, so we are in Visual Studio Code. And let's start by creating a new file, index.html. And now let's create a basic structure of HTML file. We have created a basic structure and now let's create a form. Since we will need the form to get the broker address, port number, topic to subscribe and publish, and also we will need buttons to connect, disconnect and publish messages. So let's quickly do that. So what I have done is created some edit texts, buttons and labels. I have assigned them the IDs and values. And if you would like to know the full explanation of the code, you can check the blog that is given in the description. Now in the header tag, we will create a meta tag and a title tag. Now let's create style.css file and connect it to our HTML file. Now we need to add the Paho MQTT library, so we will add that in the script tag, and using that script we will be able to use all the functionalities of MQTT in JavaScript. Also create a new JavaScript file and connect it to our HTML code. What I have done now is added a div for showing MQTT messages, and I have also added a CSS file to make the web app look good. I'm not going in the details, but you can find the code from the description. So our app looks like this after adding the CSS files. Now let's work on our JavaScript file, which is the main thing for publishing and subscribing to MQTT messages. So let's first create a function that will help us connect to the broker when connect button is pressed. Also, we will need a function when disconnect button is pressed, and we will also need a function for publishing a message. So now we will create a variable client ID, which will generate a random client ID using the random function. And then we will create the variables for host, port, username and password. And then we will read these values from the form or user interface using the IDs we have given to them. Now we will show in the message box that we are connected to the MQTT broker by editing the inner HTML of the div box. And also show the client ID that has been generated. Now we will use the functionalities of the MQTT library that we have added in the HTML file, and we will create a variable called client, which will call the client function of the library, and we will pass some variables like host, port and client ID. Now we can use the variable client to use other functions of the library. So we will set some functions such as onConnectionLost, and now we have to create a onConnectionLost function as well under this function, and we will write to the message box that the connection is lost. And then we will read the error response and print it on the message box. Similarly, we will connect another function to the client variable, on message function, which will be called when there is a message on our subscribe topic. Then we will create a function on message which will have an argument message. In the function, we can first print the message to the console. If you want to do some controlling on message, you can do here in this function. And then we can print the message and the topic name in the message div box. And now let's go back to our main function and write code for connecting to the MQTT broker. So we will write client.connect, and in it we will say on success, which will be called when we are successfully connected to MQTT broker, and here we will call the onConnect function. And now let's make onConnect function, and when we are connected to broker we can subscribe to a topic. So let's read the subscription topic from the HTML form, and then let's print it in message div box. Let's subscribe to it by calling client.subscribe function. We have made a mistake. There are two onConnect functions. Let's change the name of first onConnect function to startConnect, and similarly onDisconnect should be renamed to startDisconnect. And then let's add these functions to our HTML buttons input by adding the onClick function, so that these functions can be run when we click on the buttons. Also, we need to add the parentheses in the end of the function name. Let's run the program and check the console. I use the lowercase for Paho, we need to change that. Now let's test again using the free Mosquito broker. You can see that we have started to receive messages. Since we have subscribed to all the topics and it is a free broker, so we are receiving messages from all the topics sent by all other users on any topic. Now let's edit the start disconnect function so we can disconnect from the broker. We will add client.disconnect. And then we can print on message box that we have disconnected from the broker. Now let's write code for publishing a message. First we can read the message and topic name entered in the form in a variable. And then we will create object for sending a message. And we will call the message function from the library, and we will pass our message value. And then we will add the publish topic by assigning the value to destination name variable. And then we can publish a message. Now let's test it. We will subscribe to HV topic and send hi. We have received the message on this topic here. Now let's add the username and password. It will be added in the client.connect function like this, and you can connect to the broker with username and password now. In the end, I'm going to give you an overview of the library which we are using. So you can see that this is MQTT client function, and we need to pass host, port, client ID, and we are using this function here. The documentation is really simple. I will give the link so you can read more about it. Basically, this documentation is using everything that we have covered in the previous videos, so it will be very easy for you to implement. So that's it for this video. I will see you in the next video. Please write your questions in the comments, and I would appreciate if you subscribe and like this video.